My name is Mark Walsh, a global graduate from the UK and I have the privilege to be joined alongside Hae In and David today, and I'm super excited to get to talk to you about the transformation in BAT, the scientists and the research, and of course the culture and talent behind it.
Yeah, we're excited. Great. Thank you for inviting.
Yeah, it's great to be here.
Okay, good. I'll start with you, Hae In, if that's okay.
Yeah, that's right.
Could you tell us why you joined BAT?
During the interview process, it came out very clear to me that BAT gives the ownership to design your own career. So I very much like the fact that I can be in driving seat in defining what I would like to do.
Mm-hmm. I've joined the company a year ago. So for me, I'm hearing this is the best time to be in BAT because it's going through massive changes in the last probably 10 years.
To address the biggest impact that cigarettes have on the planet to public health, it had to start with the science behind what we call tobacco harm reduction and the products that you would develop based on that science. And when we started that journey, you know, one of the first realizations was we needed to change so much. And one of the key things that we need to change with the skills in science and R&D.
The science and the R&D was definitely ahead of the curve in terms of their transformations.
I think today 70% of the people working in global R&D have been recruited in the last, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 years. So it was really about bringing people in, not just new technical skills like electronics, but people that had been out there in startups and other FMCGs that have been really advanced in innovation to accelerate our knowledge. And of course, because we did it on such a big scale, they brought their difference. I know that's a bit of a cliche, but because so many people were recruited from the outside at once, the culture changed dramatically very quickly because they transformed us, the way we thought, the way we acted, the way we, you know, did innovation, the way we did science. You know, that for me was the one big pillar of transformation in the area of science and R&D were the people.
Okay. And just, I'm not really big on science. I'm more in the marketing side of things. You said the skills that the people need to have in science is different from 20 years ago, 10 years ago to today.
At our global conference a couple of weeks ago, a key part of my presentation was talking about the next generation of scientists that we need in this company and the sorts of skills that we've identified now that we don't have.
Okay.
So this journey will never stop, as far as I'm concerned. As long as we keep changing and transforming, we're always going to look for new people with new ideas, new skills, and add to our existing ones.
That's and what R&D went through is exactly what's happening across the business as well, because we are entering into this new territory and new business. Yeah. There are just so many capabilities that we didn't have before because we never dealt with that. So, for example, we were in tobacco business, tobacco product, and it's now becoming more like a consumer electronics and a tobacco product and modern orals. And then we'll go further beyond than that also. So, I mean, even in marketing, as you said, we never did e-commerce, digital marketing is a new area, because just the way that the product gets developed and supplied and procured are all different. Legal is different. Again, this IP knowledge and the expertise, again, not so much of the big area before, now it's a huge area. So this acquiring new capabilities, bringing new people in, and again, having the right culture to leverage on their diverse expertise and different experiences is absolutely critical. And that's why, as you said, it's the most exciting time to join BAT.
So I think you need people like graduates to promote that it's a changing industry to our friends. And then they realize the stigma with tobacco, working with tobacco on cigarettes only, which I think, what percentage of our scientists study in tobacco compared to an NGP?
Virtually none.
Exactly.
The latest generation, right? Working as part of us.
Yeah, I think that
to develop new products. Out.
Yeah, I agree.
What attracted you to BAT?
So I went on LinkedIn and I looked at top FMCG brands. I clicked into the UK and Ireland graduate program and I read the description and it talked about these potentially reduced risk products, electronic cigarettes. And I was like, this is a tobacco company. Like, what's going on here? So I went into it. I went onto the page, the website, and I just couldn't get over all of these different brands. And I said, what's happening here? So I rang up someone I know, and I said, like my dad, and I said, tell me about British American Tobacco. And he said, oh, that industry is going crazy. He said, get involved in that. He said, try and get in there. He said, because you won't, it's a super exciting time. So then I just applied, and now I'm sitting here today after finishing the grad program. I had the grad academy about 2 months ago, and there was 150 graduates from around the world. I think 50 nationalities maybe from around the world. Right. And I've planned some travel in the next few months to go visit some of them. So I'm going to Russia, I'm going to Kenya, Tanzania, Zanzibar, and I'm going to stay with some of the grads from around the world. So yeah, it was super amazing. I kind of went back to your question of why I joined, but now I know definitely why I joined.
Yeah, and that, you know, it's great that you said that, because when I joined, you know, BAT, I had a very similar experience, and I'd never really had an international perspective until I joined BAT, and you know, traveled around the world to many countries and made lots of friends that are international, and it opens your mind and your experiences.
And in this building, we have about 80 nationalities, which is almost like a UN level of the diversity. Yeah. And we have, I think, 9 nationalities in the board with 30 members in it. Yeah. So it kind of sort of broaden your horizon and enlarge your sort of the networks and experience. And that's only thing that very unique. I mean, not only thing, that's very unique thing in BAT, because we operate in 180 countries. It's not very common that you find country that has such a wide geographic coverage.
Myself and the guys back in Richmond in the UK office, we're always talking about getting to travel, and I can't wait to go to South America, maybe Russia, and work there for a few years, and then one day maybe be back in here.
You know, where else are you going to get that opportunity? Mm. And you know, that it's there for those who want that diversity of experience, and it's encouraged, right, Hae In?
It is.
Yeah, and I think that's one of the things why people stay in this company so long, because it's massive, right? You can work in any function, marketing, R&D, finance, operations. You can work in just about any country in the world, and you know, travel the world. And why would you want to leave and go anywhere else when you got this amazing opportunity? And I think we do have people, we stay with us longer than most because of the scale and the diversity of the experiences.
Yeah, like, and another thing you touched upon, sorry, is this growth potential of the industry, as your father mentioned. It's a massively growing industry where a lot of investment going, which is not common. Again, it's something rare and special these days, especially in FMCG sector. It's more of the static sort of NTO growth you see. So a lot of people who come to BAT is exactly for that reason attracted to BAT. A lot more investment going in, and then a lot of growth potential, a lot more rich professional experience that they can get in BAT, which again poses a very attractive proposition to everyone, be it global graduate or mid-career recruits.
Yeah, exactly right.
So at the Grad Academy, we had the privilege to go visit the McLaren Technology Center, because obviously of the partnership with McLaren. Mm-hmm. It was fascinating. We got to change the tire, so we had a pit stop challenge. We got to see all the old cars. It was unbelievable, incredible, and it's a phenomenal facility. It's beautiful. But my question to you both would be, talk a bit about that partnership with McLaren and British American Tobacco. What does it do for us?
One of the things that we found as we get into these new categories is we have to prototype products very rapidly and test them with consumers. And there's no one better on the planet that does rapid prototyping than a Formula One team.
Right, yeah.
Because every week they're making a whole new range of prototypes for their cars. They wind tunnel test them, they take them to the racetrack. And they say that the car at the end of the year is completely different to the car at the beginning of the year because they've prototyped it so rapidly throughout the year. And, you know, those sorts of skills and capabilities are essential for us in the new category space.
I'm not going to lie, I didn't really know much about F1, and I openly said I can't be less interested about the F1. But it was before knowing that the level of the innovation that's going on with this McLaren. And again, also, it's great to see that whenever we bring our GGs or managers, even our main board, the level of excitement that it brings, and also how much it helps that whenever we are out there recruiting during the career fair and whatnot, the level of, again, the genuine differentiation that we can gain from McLaren. So
to go out and have a meeting in a place like that, I think is very inspiring for the people that go from BAT.
And in terms of the learning, everyone definitely came back with how this fast innovation, all the process and the level of technology was mind-blowing to all of them.
But I'm a massive F1 fan, so for me it was super, super exciting.
Yeah.
Great to hear.
Yeah.
Well, what's your perception and impression of the management board amongst the GGs?
Oh, they're great.
Speak freely.
Of course you'll say that.
Yeah, I know that we can trust in them. At the graduate program, yourself, Jack, Kingsley, a few other people came down. They spoke to us and they let us know that we're here and we're all the same. And they said the possibilities of you guys coming up here is what we want. We're investing time in you, so you guys will be up on the management board.
If you really want to test that organization is living up to what they preach and promise, just look at the most senior leadership team. And is the team diverse? Is it homogeneous team?
The external perception of us is out of date, right? And I think, I'm really pleased to hear your dad good up to date.
Thanks,
you
Dad.
Good up to date view of the company. Because even now, today, when I speak to people outside and they have a view of BAT and, in fact, the industry of 20, 30 years ago, right? And it's just not like that.
Mark, you have been with us over a year now. So how has it been and what's your ambition with BAT?
It's been super exciting, really fast. I've enjoyed it thoroughly. But obviously, like any graduate, the goal is to be on the management board someday in the future. I'd love to get your take now that I have the opportunity. How do you get to the management board? What's the secret? Share with us, please.
Start with David. You got there first.
Okay. Look, I think I always, from being a graduate, I wanted to do it, right? So the first thing I'd say is it's not going to happen unless you really want to do it. And I decided, 20-something years ago, that I wanted to do this job. It's about taking risks, being bold, being curious. Everything is an opportunity to learn and advance. And as long as you keep that mentality of advancing yourself, developing yourself as a leader, learning new aspects of the business, getting more experiences, then and you want to do it, you've got a good chance.
Okay, me?
Yeah, if you do those things.
I think often misperception is that you plan for the roles in next year I'll do this role. But look, again, the structure, as you have seen, becomes very fluid because business changes so fast. Mm-hmm. So we all have to be focusing a lot on what experiences do I need to get. Okay. I think that's the formula. Yeah. And that has been the answer by every CEO, every management board member. Yeah. This is one of the FAQ from GG Academy. Okay. But without the failure, without any coordination, everyone said, look, focused on the experience and ask for the experience and assignment that gives you that exposure to the right, the opportunities, learning opportunities.
And I think that's a great point, Ian, because you've got state responsibility for yourself, right? Yeah. And then you'll get help. You'll get a lot of help. Mm-hmm. But it is, as Hae In says, about seeking those experiences and not being shy, right?
Yeah, I try not to be shy. I don't think I am. Yeah. But does it mean just project-based, getting your hands into certain projects?
It's again what you're missing in your sort of the up-to-date career and what you need to actually gain. So some actually have to work a lot more on the local project. Yeah. Depends on what your sort of the destination goal is. And then the, yes.
Yeah, good.
And then at the right stage, you focus on this experience and then you move on to the next experience that may not in different forms of the international assignment. But again, it comes down to leadership attributes. How agile are you? Yeah. How humble and open are you to learn, I think?
And I think it's great for you, Mark. You've got this destination mind of CMO, right? That's a I think that's a great objective, and I think you should work towards it.
Yeah. Towards it, yes. Often these days, what leaders look at, because it's a very tough and high-paced environment, is someone that I can trust that will deliver. It's not actually less about what specific sort of the roles the person did.
Yeah.
In every role that the task that I give this person, did the person deliver? We are at this great juncture of the changing the industry, lots of opportunities in science, in digital marketing, in the new innovative supply chain, in the new areas of the legal with IP and the finance with corporate venture capital. There are just all sorts of the portfolio of the opportunities out there. And it will be great that you come and check us out.
Yeah, but the responsibility part you said, that's another point that I came in and I was just delegated tasks. They gave me responsibility and they trusted me straight away. And I was kind of like, wow, this is a lot of responsibility to get as a graduate. Yeah. But they trust people here. And they delegate responsibility. So they help you grow and they help you challenge yourself. And that's the most important thing I've learned in the last year, that I can do certain things.
That's a key part of our global graduate program, real job from day one, that you will grow faster by having larger responsibilities earlier on your career. Yes.
So what would you say to, you know, graduates who are considering BAT, but have a little reservation? What would you say to them?
I'd say if you want to work in an organization that's super, super fast paced, that's transforming and that's truly international, I would say come to BAT and challenge yourself and grow your career. Because I went to the Graduate Academy just recently. I met 150 different people who all shared one ambition, get to the top and learn from the different cultures. So if you want a challenge, I would say BAT is the right one for you. Hae, thank you very much for everything, learning about the diversity and the culture and the talent we have in the business. David, about the new products that we have coming, I'm sure there's some exciting things to come. Thank you very much. And we're all very excited for those.
Thank you for the opportunity.
No, it's been great, Mark. Thanks. Really interesting. Thanks, Hae.
Thank you both. We'll see you next time on the next podcast. Tune in.